What's up guys, SB Architects here. Today I'm gonna be showing you custom fill pattern in ARCHICAD. We use custom fill patterns to fill inside of our projects. We can reach it from documentation toolbar, but that seems a little stuck under the toolbar, so I'm gonna minimize the design. Now we can see our document tools clearly, and we click fill. After that, you will see a couple of options. On the top part of the window, we have geometry options, fill pens, contour pens, fill type, and fill categories. For the fill category, we can see it's cut fill, so it's a little limited. To see all of them, we can go to the drafting fill, and now we will see all of the fills, but except surface and building materials, which came with the latest version of ARCHICAD, but they are off topic now. Now we are going to use drafting fills, and I'm going to make a simple rectangle. Let's click arrow, and we can see on the floor plan a solid fill. In order to change that, we can go to the fill type here, or we can go its settings. Let's hit Ctrl plus T, and we will see same settings with those. So I'm just going to close it and open up this menu. There we have our patterns, but they were grouped together. We have solid fills, gradients, vectorial fills, symbol fills, and image fills. For the vectorial fills, we can edit them, but if we want to add something, we are going to add symbol fills and also image fills. But first I'm going to show how to edit vectorial fills. So I'm going to turn this into a, for instance, let's pick up this plywood, or never mind that, I'm gonna use grid 100 and 100. So how can we change their size? If you want to turn them, for instance, 100 to 25 centimeters, you have two options here. First, you click the fill. Let's go to the construction method, and we can use the second option, which is link to fill origin. With that, we can change origin and rotation. For instance, I want to start from here and rotation, but our objective is changing its size. So we will better choose the third option, this one, which is custom distortion. Now we have two additional arrows. First one is with Z direction, and the second one is for the X direction. But the difference is, now if we click that, we can change the distance. It says 1000 millimeters. If we change this 1000 millimeter to 250 millimeters, which is 25 centimeters, and hit enter, this is 25 to 100. We have changed that. Also, you can change its rotation, something like this, but it's a bit hard to cope with that. It's orientated, distorted. So in order to get a straight rectangle, we need to have 90 degrees with this line and this line. So I'm gonna click this second line and change its rotation to 90, but as you can see, it's very hard. I don't know, maybe to do that we can use some helper lines with rectangle and align to there, rotate as you want, and now we can align our helper lines to our new rectangle. This does the trick. Once we have that, we have another option. We can go to the options menu, go to the element attributes and fills. If we find our 1-to-1 grid here, we can change it and also rotation. This is more professional way of doing this. But first, in order to change the settings, we need to duplicate. We mustn't overwrite the settings onto original pattern. So let's click new and we have duplicate here. I'm gonna change the name. It's going to be 25. Let's click OK. And let's input here 225. And also you can change the rotation. I don't know, maybe 30 centimeters, 30 degrees. There you go. Let's click OK. And if we go to the original construction method, now we can choose the second grid. There we go. We have changed our field type. Okay, let's go to the menu again. And we are in the symbol fields. Let's try, for instance, pavement 01. If we go back to the field options, element attributes, and fields. Let's go to the pavement 01. For this pavement 01, we have more parameters. Now we have scale, strokes, scale with plan, scale independent paper size. This is important. If you use this scale with plan model size, if you change your project scale, the size of these rectangle pavements will also change on the paper, of course. But if you use the second option, which is scale independent paper size, if you change your project settings, project scale, those pavement 01 size will be the same on the paper. It doesn't matter which scale you use in your project. You can see those options for every symbol fields. You can change the pattern steps, but I won't change now. If you have a custom shape to import here, we are going to use new option. We won't use solid fill, it's only solid. Image fill, by its name, it's only image. We have only left symbol fill. Let's click OK. You can change the name, by the way. Now we can see the default symbol fill pattern. But how can we use it? As you can see here, we have copy and paste. Interesting. How can we use this copy and paste in the floor plan? I'm going to make a pattern. Something like this. And a smile. Just like that. This is going to be our pattern. To do that, I'm going to copy this. But if I copy this, it's going to be something like this. But I need a space here. To do that, I'm going to use a helper for this. In the more options, we have hotspot. We are going to click new, symbol fill. I'm gonna call this as smiley. Hit the paste. And there we go. We can see our very powerful design clearly. This is the first row and this is the second row. If you want to make an offset to get brick style, we are going to input a half value of this, which is 350. Let's click OK. Now we have a brick effect. We can make the same for the vertical offset. Let's copy this value and paste here. And we will get this. There you go. In order to use any custom image, now we are going to use this image field. We are going to import it from our disk. Maybe for this station we can use ARCHICAD surface. We have some interesting images here. Maybe we can use some stonework. This time we are going to change field type to image fields. Just like that. If we click our newly created fill, we can see its fill category here is drafting fill. But for the new version, if we go to the surface cover fill, and we can directly see the element's fill type. For instance, we have tiles mosaic blue. As you can see, this is a vectorial shape. To turn this into an image fill, we are going to use this icon and use this texture fill. This is the image where the 3D window views. I have opened a 3D floor plan, and as you can see, we have some woods here, tiles, and another floor types. If we go to the ground floor, we cannot see them. We have this slab and other slabs, but we now have textures. To see the textures, we can use image fills to fill inside for this kind purpose. Let's go to the fill. We change the fill category and surface. I want to cover this area with the wood. So in the fill type, I'm going to use some parquet material. Let's try this and make a rectangle. There we go. Now we have vectorial wood pattern. To turn this into an image, we select the fill, click this icon, and surface texture fill. There we have our texture. We can just repeat these steps to fill all of the plan. There we go. You can present your floor plans in a more lively and active way. This is how you can use fills, add custom fills and image fills, and how to use them in ARCHICAD. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please hit the like button. It's very important for the YouTube algorithms to support the channel. If you want to see similar tutorials like this, please subscribe and turn on the bell. Thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day.